Tonight we welcome Black Sheep Brass Band to the stage of the Phoenix Theater. Black Sheep Brass Band is based out of Sonoma County. They have created their own unique brand of 100% certified brass-fed acoustic funk that permeates all layers of being. I'm reading straight from your promotional materials. Yeah. From the uptown to the get down, it's time for the Black Sheep to vibrate y'all to the good sound all around. Please welcome to the program the members of Black Sheep Brass Band. Welcome to the stage, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. It's great to be here.
The entire interview will be performed as sheep. Very exciting. This band is incredibly eclectic. It has a farm laborer turned attorney, a telecom worker, a homeless shelter manager. Hopefully this isn't an outdated bio. A yoga teacher, an engineer, gigging musicians with an S next to it, a graphic designer, visual artist, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. IT guy, U.S. Navy submarine veteran. I believe that's you, correct?
What?
You mentioned in some correspondence with me, and this is Max mentioned this to me, that the name of this band is, it means something. There's a reason for it. It's not just some random thing that was plucked out of the air. Would you like to go into some detail on that?
I would. And partially, yeah, just being open to when I was originally thinking about a different name from what we originated as the Jungle Love Orchestra. And after being that for about a year, you know, I was just meditating on something and I can't take ownership, you know, just the divine working through, just saying Black Sheep Brass Band has a ring to it. And after thinking about it more, it is also representational of who we are as individuals as well as a group, and just how we have developed a time over a long timetable of not having so much expectations of ourselves, but allowing from the 8 years when we were conceived on the streets of Santa Rosa as Jungle Love Orchestra into Black Sheep Brass Band, to really allow this natural thing to form and become its own through our own interactions as people came and they went, more upon the Black Sheep Brass name. It's all about representing and feeling comfortable to be our authentic selves.
You mentioned expectations as a thing that was potentially problematic.
Yeah.
How was that a problem?
So I'd say...
And anybody who's had expectation problems can jump in, but we'll start with our friend Max.
I mean, as I kind of have stepped into more of the band leader, organizer role, I've also, in the last year, had more expectations and attachments, and that was all for the better, to have like goals, you know, and get this next level grant, which we won, you know.
Congratulations,
thanks.
By the way. What's the next level grant?
It's a Creative Sonoma next level grant, $2,500 we won to help take our music to the next level. So it's helping us record a new EP, do some merch, and build a website. So things like that.
Nice.
And so anyway, my band members have felt like in the last couple gigs, you know, other stressors aside, have kind of gotten a little bit hung up at moments. And
you personally have?
Personally, yeah. Personally, when I know I can be more of my like calm, centered self. And so it's just a reminder now of like letting that go, recognizing that we are prosperous and we're on the path and we just got to continue working together. And as long as I just, keep my to-do list and finish the whole grant report and follow up, things will be, you know, all gravy.
A lot of people of a certain background say that attachment is bad.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm curious, just because I've never had it really explained to me, you can jump into, because I think you've got some thoughts on attachment. You're a free and easy guy.
I try not to be attached.
That's true. but with expectations comes attachments, it needs to be this way, and everyone else listen to me. I'm curious, so it seems like you've recognized maybe you were maybe putting your toes in the water of that sea, and your band member were like, please don't do that. I'm curious, why shouldn't one be attached? Why shouldn't one have expectations?
So the moment we have expectations, we can let ourselves down if those expectations don't come true. So if a gig doesn't go the way we planned, or I planned in my head, then I might be upset. Where if I recognize there was beauty in the gig no matter what, and just being present in the moment, then I can just be more present to enjoy the experience. So in terms of attachments, I mean, people say there's healthy attachments and expectations, but I think it comes down to just the presence we have with ourselves and the more content we are with ourselves. And some people say they're bored, and some people say that boredom is really just an anxiety of not being able to be just with yourself or with the other person you're with. And also someone might be lonely, but you're really only lonely because you don't know yourself. So as I've like tried to work on myself, this is a reflection, and this whole group process of being in the band is just a reminder of how much more work, you know, continue to do, not only with this band relationship dynamic, but also like my personal relationships, love life, and just communication in general, always room to improve.
Can I add to that?
Yeah.
That was beautiful, by the way. I've been with the band like six years or so. Yeah. And I have noticed too, since we got the grant, since, you know, it's like we have experienced this kind of narrowing, you know, it's like the gates were like this, you know, but now there's a certain amount of focus in these gigs. You know, some of the gigs pay really quite well, you know, or some of the gigs are really very high profile. And our comfort zone is, you know, a random street corner or something, you know, and there we really get into, you know, that core thing of like keeping it loose, listening, laughing off mistakes, you know, like, you know, somebody make a mistake and it'd be hilarious. And then we just keep going, we roll right over it. But then sometimes there's that pressure of these like more high profile gigs, and also this thing lingering for us about the next level. It's like, what is that? How do other people do it? How do we get in on that? You know, and that there's this paradox between like the core value and then the thing that I think that we're imagining that we might be able to get to, you know. And I think some of us would love it to be a self-sustaining thing, like where, like, it'd be great if like we play gigs and everybody loves us and we get paid really well, you know, and it's some sort of dream. But again, like, you know, so I think that we're experiencing some speed wobbles. You know, like on a skateboard, you get going too fast, you wobble around.
Because the speed has increased.
The speed has increased.
And I would imagine, because it's not just one person, it's not just two people, I would imagine that not only do you have to like manage the expectations and attachments you have with yourself, but you kind of all are in this thing together. And so you have all these different people with all these different varying ideas about what we need to do and how fast we're going and are we on the right path. So I would imagine that it gets to be a little bit of a push and pull sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's especially a process on tour, and that's the fun part, though.
But those are the best relationships, right? Yeah. Name a good relationship that you have isn't push and pull and isn't like giving. And
that's the beautiful thing about the world we live in, is that push-pull, the polarities. Like, without the polarity, we wouldn't exist. There's the argument that it's because of polarity that existence was created. And, I mean, we see it in such a sheer contrast right now in terms of the political system, from what we had prior with Obama to what we have with Trump. It's just like, oh my goodness, what a world of polarities we live in. And I can only like just marvel at it at this point. You know, it's like, oh, crazy shit.
Why does polarity amaze you? Why is it so, it almost made you speechless, it seemed.
Yeah, well, polarity is, you know, the yin and yang, the force of like the feminine and the masculine. And it's the merger of those two that create us coming into this world. You know, thanks so much to our mothers for allowing us the opportunity to develop within them. But also thanks so much to our fathers, you know, whether they are present in our lives or not. The masculine and the feminine, those polarities are so integral to how we develop. And I mean, it's not to say that, even though I appear as a man, it doesn't, you know, I still have feminine qualities. There's still the hormones and the characteristics within myself. I do what I can to nurture and develop those creative, nurturing aspects. But also I recognize where it's very important to be aware of those polarities so we can show up as just positive men in the world. Because I think that's what's needed more and more, is positive, safe men that can hold space to allow creativity to flourish. And so once again, thank you so much, Tom, for holding the space in the Phoenix Theater to allow so much creativity in terms of music to flourish over time. And thank you too, Jim, and your whole crew for just being a window to the world in the way that the world communicates so much these days is through YouTube, through this media. I used to have a big resistance to that aspect myself, but I recognize that part of that polarity is to basically give in to the ebb and the flow. And the moment we start to feel resistance is when disease and dis-ease can be felt in the body.
You were having existential dread throughout the day today. You said that before the interview.
Yeah. I'm like the hardcore music over everything guy in the band or whatever. My whole thing is like, people are spending way too much time driving to work and doing jobs and like making this whole thing run. So I'm a really big, if you're dancing and if you're playing music, you're not creating war and you're not creating like strife in the world. And so I live to make people dance. And so existential dread, I don't have a day job, and so I'm broke as hell, and I'm just constantly having to face like, is it worth it? Do I just keep struggling with this? I don't have any money, but I get to play music, and what am I going to do in 20 years, and all of that stuff.
You talk polarity, you talk existential dread, you talk your day. Your day was one of polarity.
Yes, absolutely.
And you look at the first half.
Yeah, and that's every
and
day
then you
for
look
me.
At the
yeah, yeah.
I think that's every day for a lot of us. Yeah. Whether we admit it or not, I think that we all have polarity in ourselves. We have battles, you know, any good relationship has push and pull. Well, we also have relationships with ourselves, and I think most people have that push and pull inside themselves.
And with your instrument, too, you know.
Totally.
Like the battle against the instrument, especially. Mm-hmm. I don't know, for the brass guys.
For musicians, yeah.
Yeah, it's a meditation just to continue to practice to keep up your chops, let alone the practice of existing in this world of polarities so that it doesn't overrun our lives. It's the whole act, don't react motto, which is the idea being we have a neutral aspect of our mind, a positive aspect of our mind, in the negative aspect of our mind. Usually, you know, we can be in the negative aspect, which is like, oh, is this safe? You know, protective aspect. And then once we recognize this is safe, then we can move into the positive aspect. Oh, what can I learn from this? And then when we're in the neutral aspect of our mind, which that meditation and that practice helps us be in more regularly, then those polarities and those ups and downs of life can help us just be more, you know, midway and just enjoy when we have highs, enjoy when we have lows, but not have those attachments or expectations like, why don't I have the highs now? Why does it suck right now? But rather just being, oh, it sucks.
I deserve the highs always.
Yeah, always.
Oh, it'll get better, I guess.
I'm playing a character to illustrate your point.
I know. You do deserve the highs always, though.
First of all, Tom, do you have any thoughts on the Black Sheep brass band experience?
You know what? Here. I got to ask this question. First off, this is the first time we've ever had a submariner on the show. And we've been talking an awful lot about polarity. So I got to ask, have you ever gone under the polar ice in the submarine?
Well, yes, I have.
Yes, you have. This man was working on polarity before some of you guys were even born.
And I'm really glad that you pointed the attention to our friend there. Before the interview, you had expressed some concern that this thing was going to be long-winded, and it's like, what the hell are you doing talking for an hour? I hope that it wasn't too much bullshit for you. I hope that it wasn't the worst experience you ever had. Was it all right?
I thoroughly enjoyed myself.
And we need to get him out of here in time to get tacos.
That's true. We only have 16 minutes until tacos. Mm-hmm. I think we covered a lot, and I would also say I think you guys I really appreciate how open you were tonight and kind of getting to the nitty-gritty here.
Thank
because I think all of these feelings, all these emotions, all these intents, are channeled into the music. And I think people listen to the music and they love the music, but it's really interesting to get to know what brought the people here and who these people are that are playing for them. So thank you for sharing that with us tonight.
Absolutely. Thanks for coming and doing this.
Thank you so much.
And best of luck. I hope that the trajectory continues in the direction it seems that it is going. And I hope that the growing pains continue, but they are overcome.
Toy pains and lessons to learn from.
Yes. So the interview is over. Thank you guys for joining us. And in just a moment,
it's taco time.
Well, Tom, it's taco time.
No, you know what?
But also,
you got to stick around and listen to what these guys put out there.
Yes, because Black Sheep Brass Band is going to play a selection of songs for you. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Love me, move me, baby, love. love you, love so true. I wanna love on you and kiss on you till the moon turned blue. I wanna love on you and kiss on you all night
we
Feels like I'm losing myself in all the best ways.
With iPhone, smartphones, am I going home? Apps perhaps I give you this life all wrapped up in a shimmering package of sleep mystique, reminiscent of photographs, antique, but wait, that ain't built to last, unlike a great-great-grandfather's class. Or his hand tools passed down from generation to generation until, wait, there's an app for that. Throw away those antiques unique, those tools of the work trade. Throw away those skills to pay the bills. All you need to learn is numbers, how to punch buttons and tap touch screens, and you'll be taken care of. Living in the land of your dreams, living in the land of your dreams. Show! Screen app producing machine. An app won't fix your tire when it's flat. An app won't build your house. An app won't sow your seeds. An app won't bandage you up when you bleed. Sure, Plato's cave can show you how life could be. And remember, this is only one perspective on life's endless creativity, endless creativity. Living in the land of your dreams, living in the land of your dreams. Sure.
That's all we know.